You are welcome in the class of Laplace Transform. We are in the module number 4 of M201 Mathematics 2 course. In this module, already we have covered up the basic properties, definitions and applications of Laplace Transform, which includes first shifting property, second shifting property, change of scale, multiplication of a function by t, as well as division of a function by t and its corresponding Laplace transforms. We have also discussed the elementary Laplace transforms of some elementary functions, basically, which is used as some informations in the further problems. In this class, we are going to discuss the Laplace transform of derivative of a function. That means if a function is given to us and we know its Laplace transform, then what will be the Laplace transform of that given function's derivative? With the property, we can find it out. We are not going to apply the differentiation of that function and then we are applying Laplace transform from its definition. It will be a large and huge thing. Instead of that, we are going to check it out. So let us start the thing. So the property is like that: if ft be continuous and Laplace transform of ft is fs, then Laplace transform of the derivative of the given function denoted by f dash t will be minus f0 plus s f bar s. So it is clearly noted over here that if fs is known, f bar s is known, we can find out f0, f bar s, and we can find out the Laplace transform of f dash t with this property. So we can have some little generalization of this because it is going to be very helpful when we are going to find out the solution of ordinary differential equation applying Laplace transform. So here we can write if ft and its first n minus 1 derivatives, it is nothing but the generalization, derivatives be continuous, then we can write Laplace transform of fnt, that means nth derivative of f. We are trying to find out the Laplace transform of that one. It will be minus f of n minus 1, 0, minus s f n minus 2, 0, minus dot dot dot, then minus s to the power n minus 1, f 0, plus Sn f bar s. And we can easily identify that if we put n equal to 1 in the second property, we will get the first property. So second one is the generalization, first one is the property for first order differentiation. Now here some points are to be noted that by any means, if we get just it is an observation that if f0 is equal to f dash 0 is equal to dot dot dot, all are 0, then we get Laplace transform of f dash t is equal to is Laplace transform of ft. That means f bar s, because here f0 is 0. And similarly, we can go for more generalizations. That is Laplace transform of f double dash t is equal to s square Laplace transform of ft. And in this way, we can get Laplace transform of fnt is equal to s to the power n Laplace transform of ft. So, this is a very important observation, because they are going to be useful for solving differential equations in the coming classes. So now, we are going to exhibit some problems based on this property. First problem is given like that. Given ft is equal to t plus 1, the range of t is also given, t is within 0 to 2, and ft is equal to 3 when t is greater than 2. Suppose we have to find out Laplace transform of ft and Laplace transform of f dash t. So, by definition, Laplace transform of ft will be integration 0 to infinity e to the power minus st ft dt, which is equal to 0 to 2 e to the power minus st t plus 1 dt plus 2 to infinity e to the power minus st into 3 dt. So, this integration will give us as t plus 1 e to the power minus st by minus s minus e to the power minus st by s square 0 to 2, because it is not an improper integration, we can just use integration by parts, plus the rest part is an improper integration. So, limit b tends to infinity 3 integration 2 to infinity e to the power minus st dt. So, now by doing the calculations and simplifications, we can write it as I am keeping these simplifications for you and also this one. We can go for the result as minus 3 e to the power minus 2s by s minus e to the power minus 2s by s square plus 1 by s plus 1 by s square plus 3 e to the power minus 2s by s. And simplifying, finally, we will get it as 1 by s plus 1 by s square into 1 minus e to the power minus 2s. Now, we are going to apply the property of Laplace transform of f dash t, and in this case, The formula tells us that it will be minus f0 plus s Laplace transform of ft. So here our observation is that f0 is 1, because f0 will be calculated from the first part, and if we put 0 here in place of t, it will be f0 equal to 1. So Laplace transform of f dash t will become minus 1 plus s into fs. Here fs is 1 by s plus 1 by s square, 1 minus e to the power minus 2s. So simplifying, we can write it as 1 by s, because here s and s will be cancelled out, 1 minus 1 and plus 1 will be cancelled out. So 1 by s into 1 minus e to the power minus 2s. This will be the answer of this problem applying the property in this case. So similarly, we can have some more problems for this particular property. This is a very easy property, but it is also very much useful. So what we can get as another example, that find Laplace transform of ft is equal to t sine at, but it is mentioned that using, look at this, we can find out Laplace transform of sine at, then we can find out the result by multiplication of t. But here it is mentioned that using the property of Laplace transform of derivative. So if I have to do this, first of all we have to think about the plan, that how we are going to perform this problem using the concept of derivatives of Laplace transform. Okay. So now we have to plan, but how it can be done using the properties. So think about the sin at. And how we can manage it by the property of derivatives in this context. So if I think like this, here f dash t, f t is given. So you can write f dash t as sin at plus at cos at, and f double dash t is equal to a cos at plus a cos at minus at sin at. Just simple first order and second order differentiation, and we can write it as 2a cos at minus a square t sin at. One thing to observe, that f0 is 0 as well as f dash 0 is also 0. So we can now, using the result Laplace transform of f double dash t Look at this, it is a beautiful technique or rather tool what I am going to show you. Minus f dash 0 minus s f 0 plus s square Laplace transform of f t, or you can go for the previous slides note where we can see that it is nothing but s square Laplace transform of s square Laplace transform of f t, because the other two terms are 0. So we can write Laplace transform of 2a cos a t minus a square t sin a t is equal to a square, and Laplace transform of f t means Laplace transform of sin a t. So I am writing it as Laplace transform of t sin a t. Okay. So in the next line, we can write it as 2a, applying cos a t, its Laplace transform s by s square plus s square is equal to, here Laplace transform of t sin a t. Here is also Laplace transform of t sin a t. So taking it in the right hand side, we can write it as a square plus a square Laplace transform of t sin a t. And in the next line, we can write it as Laplace transform of t sin a t is equal to 2as by s square plus s square whole square. So this is the answer what we have got for the Laplace transform of t sin a t without applying this. But here is a request to all of you, perform this problem, perform the same by rule of multiplication by t and compare, and compare, then it will be a constructive conceptual idea in your mind. So I am not extending this class. You can obviously go for these references for more practices and better knowledge, as well as along with these assignments also you please perform the problem of others related to this. Finally, I want to thank you all. Happy listening, happy learning.